Hello students, this side Pallavi, your English teacher. Hope you all are fine and doing your studies sincerely. Students, today I am here to discuss a very important topic, that is verb. Now let me start with the definition of verb. A word used to describe an action, state or occurrence and forming the main part of the predicate of a sentence is called a verb. Students, basically we say that verbs are some action words. Right now I am speaking. Speaking is an action word. You are listening. You are writing. I am teaching. All these are action words. And these action words are called verb. Verb is the main part of the predicate. Students, when we have done the topic of sentences, in that topic I have told you that there are two main parts of a sentence. One is subject and the other one is predicate. So students, verb forms the main part of the predicate. Now what a verb expresses? First is what a person or thing does. Example, he writes a letter. Here writes is a verb and it is indicating that what a person or thing does. Second is what is done to a person or thing. A letter is written by him. Here this underlined word written is a verb and it is showing that what is done to a person or thing. Third is existence and state of being. He is a teacher. Here is a verb. Some students get confused that is, am, are, these are the helping verbs. But in this sentence, is working the work of a main verb. Here it is used as a main verb. He is a teacher. So it is showing the existence. That is a pencil. State of being. Next point is position. He has a car. Here has word is used as a verb. I have a pen. And these verbs are showing position. He has a car. I have a pen. Now students, here are the types of verbs. Main verb and helping verb. These are the two main types of a verb. And there are further types of main verb. One is finite verb and the other one is non-finite verb. Here that finite verb are also divided into two categories, transitive verb and intransitive verb. And non-finite verbs are divided into three categories. One is gerund, infinitive and participles. This assignment has already been given to you people and I hope that you have done this topic in your FAIR notebooks also. And now we will do all these types in detail. First we are doing finite verb. What is a finite verb? A finite verb is directly linked to a subject. This is the main thing, students, which you have to keep in mind, that a finite verb is directly linked to a subject. In a sentence, I have already told you that there are two parts, subject and predicate. And predicate part is made up of two components, that is verb and object. So in that predicate part, one verb is always present there and you have to identify whether the verb is finite verb or non-finite verb. So finite verb is the verb which is directly linked to a subject. It agrees with the subject in person and number and changes its form. Students, this is the main thing. Changes its form means finite verb is one which changes its form when the subject changes. It indicates the tense. For example, Shaina and Rustam play badminton. Here this is your subject. And this one is your predicate part. And in this predicate part, play is your verb and badminton is your object. So students, in this sentence, you can see that subject is Saina and Rustam. Play is a verb and badminton is your object. Here play is a finite verb. Why it is a finite verb? because it will get change if we will change the subject. Like Saina plays better than Rustam. Here we have changed the subject and the verb gets changed. It means the verb is finite verb. Next example, they played a friendly match yesterday. Here the same verb play changed into played. How it is changed? Because we have changed the subject. So students, you have to keep in mind that when we change the subject and verb is affected by it, then the verb is our finite verb. Students, I hope finite verb is clear to you all. Now we are doing the types of finite verb. There are two types of finite verb, transitive verb and intransitive verb. Now, what is transitive verb? Verbs that need a direct object to complete their action or to convey their meaning fully are called transitive verbs. Means the verbs which require an object to clear its meaning, that is called our transitive verb. Example, I want a book. Here I is a subject, want is a verb, a book is a object. If we are not writing here a object, a book, I want, what I want, the meaning is not clear. So the verb which needs an object to clear its meaning is called transitive verb. Next example is Anil moved the chair. Anil moved the chair. Here the chair is object. Suparna has many friends. Here many friends is a object. So a verb which require a object to clear its meaning is called transitive verb. They gave me a pen. Now second is intransitive verb. This is the opposite of transitive. Verbs that do not need an object. Here we need an object, but here we do not need an object to convey their meaning are called intransitive verbs. For example, Akash ran. Here the sense is clear in itself. There is no need of writing any object. So object is not required here. The dog barks. The meaning is clear. This is subject and this is verb. Now there is no need of object. I play daily. Rakshita was weeping. So the verbs which do not require any object to clear its meaning are called intransitive verb. Students, I hope this is clear to you all. Students, in this video we have done verb, finite verb and its type, transitive verb and intransitive verb. Now we will do non-finite verbs in our next video lecture. So till then, goodbye.